वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकान्त राधाकान्त तप्तकञ्चन गौराङ्गीराधी विशुभानुसुते देवी प्रणमा वृन्दाय तुलसीदत्तै प्रियायै केशवस्य च श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे
lakhs and lakhs of them were pranam to my lotus feet of my Gurudev Shishila Bhakti Pragyan Kesha Goswami also I am offering my so many dandvas in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pasa Shri Bhakti Vedan Swami Maharaj. I also want to convey my dandvas pranam to my most bosom friend Sri Sri Nitya Lila Pravishtam Sri Sri Gaurkodhan Maharaj. You know the relation, my relation to Swamiji. I have told you, and all are acquainted with this. From 46, I was connected to Swami Maharaj, and still I am connected. I think that Gaur Govind Maharaj made me just at this time when Swamiji was leaving this world. And I was there. Swami Maharaj has called me to meet in his last days. After my a talk with him, he never talked anything ever for me. So when I was there, Swami was very happy to see me, and tears were coming in his eyes. And he told that, oh, everything will be managed very well. Because he was thinking, what will be in my last days? Who will be my samadhi? And who will all be? But when he knew that Narayan Maharaj has come, he was so satisfied. It is told in some what?
Biography.
Yeah.
Biography.
It is. And he told his disciples, especially to Tamal Krishna Swami, that now I am not worried, I am satisfied that he has come. And he took me to sit on his own bed. But I did pranam to that, and I sat on the chair very nearby to him. And he, first he told me so many things. So I told all these things. When our talk were ended, then he told me, Rao Tamal Krishna, Brahmananda, and all the senior sannyasi of GVC. Hear what he wants to tell. I told them, you should never think that Swami is dying and he will be dead. Don't. You should say that he is ever thought, he is
living forever. Living forever.
He will not die. He will not die. But he can hide himself from us because you are not Dhanothai. And he wants something from you. So, I told them, don't quarrel after his guru, possibly. You should understand all this. He is with you and he is giving mercy. So, you should do his service, obey him, his teachings, always remember. And don't quarrel for money, for prestige, for worldly anything. It is in that after going, Acharya disciples have so many quarrels and all that. So, yes, of course. you should try to away from me and to preach more and more. And this, by this service, you will be so much glad. He told again that I brought so many boys. They are not so well
trained.
I request you to train, to give him help, and also, yes, sir, try to give my samadhi from our own hands. And yes, sir, try to manage my
Vira
separation utsav. I took it, his orders on my head. He told them all that you should go and take Maharaj to the temple and all the places where I've done something. Then the Mahakrishna and all the singers were coming to meet me, and so where he is to take bath, where he is to take some. Back to right, to back to do all these things. And I think that we met here with Guru Gobind Maharaj. He was very, very, very learned person, and he had come in a very devotee family. His father and mother were Vaishnava. In our line, Vaishnava line. So from boyhood, was brought up in the in a line of Vaishnava. So from when he had not joined ISKCON, he was of that spirit, inborn Vaishnava. And he has some so much impression from his last months. We can imagine that thing, that a person cannot do Krishna bhajan from boyhood. When you met Swamiji or your Gurudev, then you inclined to do some bhajan. But he has some past impression. I think for me that when I burn, I don't know from where I'm chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. From very boyhood, where there was sense, all are telling that, oh, you chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Because I was also in this same like family, Vaishnava family, my father and mothers, all there. Brahmins, not so called Brahmins, but really Brahmins, and really Sri Sampradaya Vaishnava. Ramanuja Sampradaya. Tulsi Mala and all. So it was with him. And from boyhood he was brought up in that manner. So he was so humble. He was so learned person. He was Vaishnava actually. When he met me, I was charmed that, oh, he's a very good devotee. You know that I always give classes on Vrindavan Leela. Anything philosophical, but yet I will, it will be end into and turned into Radha Krishna Master. Anything that at first I have so much trust in philosophy. But after that, I left it. Hearing these slokas of Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Anartha Picharim Chirat Kamina, Samarpayitum Unnatottalam, Prasamsa Bhakti Sriyam, Harihapurva Sundar, Dhuti Kadamba Shadi, Sadari Daya Kandaris. So, I left all this Vedanta, Athato Brahma Jigyasa, Tattamasi, and all the Vedanta Sutra. I read Gita, but after that, that test was also gone. Sarva Dharma Anupatitya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is also external. And I don't know why my test came. For Krishna pastimes. Especially with gopis. That's in Raya Ramananda Sambhad we are going to explain. So I saw all these things and qualities in Guru Govinda Maharaj. He was in the same line in which Swami Ji was. And in which so a bosom friendship was increasing. Last summer I went to Puri to write some books. When he heard, he at once came from Bhuvaneshwar.
94.
And invited me to come to Puri. But unluckily I could not go there. But once I have been there. When Guru Govind Maharaj was not in Bhuvaneshwar, but he was in Western countries, anywhere, I don't know where he was. Your disciples so much gave me honor. Then I returned to Calcutta. So I know, I have read his books. When I was coming here, his disciple presented me his two books, newly written by him and published, about Raramanand Sambhada or anything. That book. And I saw. So, he was in Raganuga, very bad doing. In this world, Raganuga, Sadhar Vaishnava are very, very rare. For which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came. I know that some of his god brothers, they opposed for this. And for this he was so much disturbed. I know this fact. But I don't fear for anyone, from anyone in this world. I only fear from Vaishnava offenses. Nothing. Whole world will be one side. Like Swamiji and my Gurudev, I can stand alone if whole world be one side. I don't care. I care for bona fide Vaishnavas, bona fide Gurus, and in all disciplic lines all acharyas. So, in his last time, last day, he was not honored. Because I think that they were not so advanced in bhakti cult. That is why, maybe. Or anyhow, I don't know. But I honor him as a pure Vaishnava. And he was shooting. Luckily I have come to this place and seen and reminding. So I am giving my Pushpanjali to his lotus feet. No light?
No, this is the first time we are in America in lotus setting. First time in America in lotus setting.
No, we are in India now.
Candle? Lantern?
Explain one sloka. Nanopachar kritapujanam artabandho premnaiva bhakta hridayam sukha vidyutam syat जावत खुदन्ति जठरे जरठा पिपाशा तावत सुखाय भवतो ननु भक्षि. यू कैन रीड द मीनिंग एंड पर्पस ऑफ दिस श्लोक देन आई विल एक्सप्लेन.
Ramananda Rai continued.
You should try very patiently and very deeply. Then you will realize the meaning. And you will be very much satisfied like that.
As long as there is hunger and thirst, eating and drinking make one feel very happy. When the Lord is worshipped with pure love, transcendental bliss is awakened in the heart of the devotee. There's no purport to this verse, but there's a very long purport to Krishna Bhakti Rasa Bhavita. Next verse. Yeah.
Here, I told the meaning. And you are sharing the meaning. That if you are hungry, you are hungry and thirsty, then there is a value of that water and that food. And you will have taste in that water and in that food. If you have no hunger, you are not hungry, you are not feeling thirsty, then how beautiful things, water or any sharbat. Sharbat, you know? Sweet water. But, what is this water? I should keep it. If you are not hungry, you are not hungry, and so many delicious things are coming, then, what is this? What is this? I took something. Very good. No taste. But you are so hungry, so much hungry. Whole day you have not taken anything. And so thirsty, like Ranti Dev in Srimad Bhagavatam. You know Ranti Dev? No?
Yes.
So thirsty. He had no water for 5 days, 6 days. Nothing, no water, nothing to food, to eat. And if you have like hunger like that, like hungry, like this, then anything without ghee and without butter, only roti of Indian,
chapati,
without ghee, dry, or chawal and dal. And you will say, very tasteful, very tasteful. But if you are not hungry, not tasteful. So it depends on your hunger and
thirst.
Then if you have prem, love, affection for Krishna, and if you offer anything, then Krishna will be happy. And if you have no prem, no affection, like Duryodhan, like Jarasandha, Kamsa, they will give your attack. But anything which is not good, not tasteful, but yet Krishna takes. So it depends on prem. But example is opposite. You should try to understand. Not very easy. Not very easy. To explain this sloka, want some service of Gurudev. Without serving and without coming in the contact of our Gurudev, not hearing from him, cannot adjust. We cannot deeply think about this. If anyone has no hunger, if he is no hungry, and he is not thirsty, then test will not come. But in this sloka it has been told also that if anyone has no prem, love, affection for Krishna, then Krishna will not be happy. So example is not proper. It thinks, we think like this, but it is not so. The example has given full treatments.
Correct.
Correct. But you should understand that if one man is hungry, then anything without ghee and without taste, it will be very tasteful. Why to Krishna? If you have prem for Krishna, then we should be satisfied, we should taste, but it is told that Krishna will be happy. Why? Krishna is always Atmaram, Atmakam. He has nothing to take from anything and he is happy. Nothing from anyone. He will never be hungry, like his Brahma, self-satisfied, no desire at all. We have so many desires. We have so many. So I was telling, give attention. Give attention. Don't look behind. So if we have love, affection of Krishna and offering, then we should be satisfied, we should be happy, we should taste it. Why Krishna? It has told in this shloka that Krishna will be happy. Why it has been told? Suppose we understand this thing or not?
Yes.
Not very well. Why? Again, try to understand. I have some affection for Krishna. I am offering Krishna with my heart. Then, savai punsang paro dharmo jato bhakti radhokhache ahetukya pratihatta jayatma samprasidati. What is the meaning of samprasidati? Samprasidita.
Fully satisfied.
Who?
Krishna. Why? Because he is the soul.
Atma means myself.
But in this shloka.
Why?
Because he is the soul, the Atma.
Same meaning here. We are serving Krishna. But hunger is in me. Love, affection in me and okay. The meaning is very deep, that if any devotee is offering anything from his heart with love and affection, then Krishna will have appetite, otherwise not. Why? Because he is nirgun, no ambition, no appetite, nothing. He is Brahma Parabrahma. No wish, nothing. Nirakar, Niranjan, Nirvishesh, Nirgun. For whom? Those by mind think that Krishna is Parabrahma. I am same. All are same Brahma. Tattam Asi. This is Vedanta. Shankaracharya explained like this, but our acharyas have not explained like this. We are the servant of Brahma. We are also Brahma, a part and parcel of Brahma. So all we are servant. And in Shankar Advaita philosophy, all we are all Brahma and we will mix at last. But here we will meet. But how we will meet? Like we have so many persons here, so many devotees, not entering in. Anyone not like being, what is the name of this Prabhu?
Vaishnavananda.
Vaishnavananda. We have come here and meet, and you have come to me and meeting with me, but you have not become Narayan Maharaj. You are the same Prabhu, same Prabhu, same Prabhu, and Narayan Maharaj. Like a bird going in the
nest.
Nest. We cannot see from outside, but she is like bird there. So we can go to Golok Vrindavan. We cannot see, but there lakhs and lakhs gopis, gopis, servants, lakhs and lakhs cows, so many mountains, so many rivers, so many animals, so many all things. Anyone cannot mix in. You know, they say that a glass of water. Bring one glass of full water, full brim, mixed. Then all will be water, mixing in water. So there will be no difference. When Ganges goes into sea, everything mixed. No Ganga, everything becomes water. But it is wrong. A particle of water does not mix in other particles of water. If through brims, full brims of water, and make them, then all will fall down. Understand? Or not? If there are two glasses of water and we have one glass to take and mix the water. Water will not mix. It will
overflow
and fall down. If they are becoming one, they cannot
overflow.
But not become one. Quantity is going on. Growing. So there are not mixing each other. But we are not saying we cannot define it. Example take. There are a heap of stones. Or there are so many lakhs and lakhs seagoats. Seagoats means?
Seagoats.
And a person is taking care of all this by his sticks. Take any of seagoat and mix in them. You cannot take it out again. But who is controlling and seeing and watching, he makes. But all these sea goats will not, never mix. I took a sea goat and get colored anywhere, red, and let him mix in the
others.
And easily I can take that. Oh, see. Similarly, any jeev cannot mix with Brahma. But they define that. So, if anyone seeing that Krishna has no appetite, no desire, no taste, nothing, he has no indriya senses, then he is not correct. So when we see that I want to give something of Krishna, I have appetite, so Krishna may have appetite. And he is so eager to give Krishna and waiting for Krishna. When Krishna will come that day. Like Yashoda, like gopis, they are preparing so many good things, festival. So many things, and oh Kanai, come on, my dear son, come on. Your father is hungry, he is waiting for you. Then Krishna goes there dancing, and he sits in the laps of his father. Says, oh father, I am so hungry. Otherwise, Krishna never be hungry. So here, Yashoda has given offering Krishna. So in the same way, if we are offering anything and we are eager that Krishna should be, then Krishna will have appetite, surely. And he will take and taste and he will be pleased. And seeing that he is pleased, myself also be pleased. The example is like that. I think you have understood something. So he is telling that so if you have no friend like this, Krishna will not please, and then you will also not. Brahma Jnani see that my Atma, my soul is Brahma. I am myself Brahma. But the devotees see that I am servant of Krishna. Be very solitary with Krishna. So if you do bhakti, then Atma of Atma, soul of soul, is Krishna. He will be pleased. So Jayatma Samprasiddhi. We should not try to only realize our soul, but we should try to know Krishna, who is Krishna. Automatically we can see. If sun rises, we can see sun, and by his help we can see everything and also us. So by serving Krishna, everyone is pleased, myself will be pleased. And if you are trying to please ourselves, then nothing. Like in night, we cannot see sun by our lakhs and lakhs efforts. When sun will come, rise and we can see. So when the mercy of Krishna will be done to us, then we will realize everything. Don't try in worldly manners without Guru. You will try and you will fail. So in Upanishad also it is told like so. যখন তাকে বরণ করে তখন জানে and he will say, oh, he is qualified now, get my mercy. And then we can, otherwise by our senses, lacks and lacks efforts, we can. The efforts we are doing, that is by the bhakti. And prem descending from there as in the shape of Vishuddha Sattva. It comes by the mercy of Krishna. There are three kinds of devotees in Golok Vrindavan. The Unka Parika?
Associates.
Are of three kinds. Nitya Siddha. Sadhana Siddha. And Kripa Siddha. Nitya Siddha, they are not like Divas. If Divas are there, they have never tested this world. Very far away from illusory Maya. Nitya Siddha. And after that, there are so many parikas of Krishna. They are Kaya Viva Baladeva Prabhu or Srimati Radhika. All these sakris are Kaya Viva manifested through
expansion
of Srimati Radhika. And other jivas are like expansion of Baladeva Prabhu. And after this, those jivas who have come from Baladeva Prabhu are Nitya Siddha. And those who are in control of Pranabdushai Vishnu, from there they come down. They are of two kinds. One practicing bhakti yoga and going there, and others without practicing, by the mercy of Krishna or our devotee, Kripa Siddha they are. They will again never come, they will return from there. So this, we can come to this world, overcome, if any person, any devotee is sent from there by the wish of Krishna. They are Nitya Siddha Parikar, like Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami, Bhakti Vinoda Goswami, like my Guru. They are not souls, worldly souls. Conditions. So, by their mercy, we can go forward, otherwise no. If anyone has a guru like this, they are so fortunate. And those who have any guru and again he falls, like in world sea, in this world sea, that he has made any guru, and after some time he fell. He made another, and again. He another, and again. Well, dead. It seems that we have no such impression of birth, last births. That is. But if you will surrender yourself in the lotus feet of Krishna, or any Vaishnava, they will take us in a life. So we should see where their bona fide gurus are not. How we can know? We are for so many years in Vaishnava association, and the symptoms have been given in Srimad Bhagavatam. So we can see. तस्मात् गुरुं प्रपद्येत जिज्ञासु श्रय उत्तमं साप्ते परिचनिष्णातं ब्रह्मनुपश्यामः. I'm not going to explain about this thing. I want to go forward something. Then he told, what I explained, it is for Vaidhi Bhakti. If no prem, Krishna will not be controlled, but he may be happy. And he can give worldly wealth, reputations, he can give salvation to all heaven. And so many lokas, like Patal Lok, Brahma Lok, all those. He can also give lower lok from Shankar, and that is called Brahma Lok. Brahma Shai Vidya. But Vaishnavas don't take. If Krishna is giving, throwing all these things towards him, no, I don't want. They have nothing to do with all this. They want to tell of this salvation. Even Dwarka they want, they never want. A Krishna having no bansi, no peacock feather here, and he is not telling that I am the son of Yashoda and Nanda. Even Krishna, they don't like that Krishna. They think that, he may be Dwarka. No connection with him. So many pranams to you. If you have any power, you can bless me that I may serve Krishna and Radha in Vrindavan. Now he is telling, if they have any past impression, From where? Not by Sukriti. By the blessings of Vaishnavas. Unconditional mercy. Then, they will come in this life. But they have two lines. From beginning of Shraddha. You know, what is the Parikasa?
Definition.
Definition of Shraddha. What is the seed of Bhakti?
Right.
Please tell like this, but in fact, it is not true. These are, when Shraddha we see, it is external symptoms. What is internal system?
Symptom.
What is that? Guru gives this seed. The tendency of serving Krishna and Radha. When I am telling Krishna, then you should add Srimati Radhika also. Without power, Krishna cannot live alone. Shakti, Shakti, Matura. When I will speak of Krishna, then you should think that also Srimati Radhika, power, energy, attribute, all are there. And Srimati is there. So here, I want to serve Krishna. This mood is the seed of bhakti and Gurudev gives the seed in our heart. At first he clears the heart, make it fertile, and then gives this. This is the root of bhakti, that is called seed. Bhakti seed. Then the outer symptom, the external will be seen like Shraddha. What is called Shraddha? What is called Shraddha? Faith in Guru Vakya, faith in Shastra Vakya, faith in Krishna teaching. Hari, Guru, Vaishnava, that I will serve Krishna. If and will cut my head, if and cut in pieces, so many pieces, I will never give up. Hari Bhajan, chanting of Krishna, worshipping of Krishna. I will die by not eating. I will live in one tree, one night here and there, having nothing, but yet I cannot give up. Like Haridas Thakur he told. You remember perhaps?
Khanda khanda.
Khanda khanda jadi jai. Why
they
have to die? Tomi badane na chali. He tell to the murderers, demons of Chandakaji, that if you cut me in pieces, I can never give up. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
This is called bona fide Shraddha. So we should have this bona fide Shraddha. How you know? From where? From Guru Vakya, from Shastra Vakya. All Shastra are spreading. That if anyone will chant one Harinam, even he will overcome all the birth and deaths, endless ocean of that suffering and sorrow. Certainly. So, when a person has such a strong belief, then Shraddha comes. Ataka is known. So, this Shraddha is of two kinds. One according to Shastra. By fearing of all these worldly miseries and sorrow and sufferings, then we chant, oh, to overcome all these things, then it is called Shraddha, but Vaidhi Bhakti. It will give Shraddha, Vaidhi Bhakti. And those who are hearing from any Rasik Bhava Bhakta, and Shraddha comes that, oh, we should try to worship Krishna. we will try to serve Krishna. Then this sattva will lead us to Radhan Baba. Like Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, like our disciplic acharyas, up to Swamiji. If that greed comes, a very lean and thin, then what becomes? Very rare, but if it comes, then he obeys some rule and regulation, may not. See, be so wicked person, drunkard, mixing with pot stores, so many pot, calm,
lusty,
angry, so many disqualities may be there, but hearing something from bona fide Vaishnavas, this greed can come, and it will lead us to Radhan Garbhajan. Now he is telling about this. Krishna Bhakti Rasabhavita Mati Kriyatam Kuto Vijati Lakshati Tatra Laulamapa Mulya Mekalam Janma Koti Sukratir Nalakshati. You know, I have told in morning class that if anyone is doing some good activities and that is called Punya Karma, and he will, in return, he will have heaven or all these things. He will be prosperous in this world. He may be happy, be wealthy in all these things. But Sukriti, it will add some bhakti, and it will lead us to one of Vaishnavas. And by their mercy, we will know Shramanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasevanam, Rachanam, Pandam, Rasanam. What is not it that we are doing, but no taste. We have heard that we should try to chant Hari name. We are chanting, but sleep comes, idleness comes. When that stop Harikatha, I am going here. No taste. What should we do? Or even that we are now not feeling stressed, but yet we will have to. This is Bhakti. When we are hearing Katha, then some sleepiness will come. And when we will dance, taking Mridanga, Karta, then no sleep at all. And when taking the Guru Mantra here, inside, no tongue used, then all kinds of evil things will come in mind, and if you keep them away from your mind, then sleep. Then Om Bhur Bhuva. But if you have taste, it will be very tasteful. You can sit like this and chanting 1 lakh at one sitting. Hearing Harikatha like Parikshit Maharaj, 7 days continuously, no stopping, no, not stopping. He told that you said, take a glass of water, he told him, no, no. I'm taking a piece of nectar of hearing Harikatha. So much taste. In worshipping, so much taste. In hearing Harikatha, so much taste. In honoring Vaishnava, so much taste. In all kinds of 8 and 9 kinds of very tasteful, very tasteful. But if not tasteful, then you should think that it is Vaidhya. But yet you will have to do continuously. Mind is not liking, but I should do. This is called bhakti. And Raganuga, at once Ruchi comes galloping, for galloping, Shraddha, all kinds of offenses, namaparad, and all kinds of anartha, anartha, you know, there are so many kinds of anartha. Galloping this, nishtha, even galloping nishtha, ruchi also, asakti comes there, from that. So if we are not testing, chanting, remembering, hearing, we cannot go in raganuga. That is very hard. But if you are hearing, we have no qualification at all. We are not even Hari name has been given initiated, but even like Haridas Thakur, he was not initiated by anyone. But he had this association of Advaita Acharya. And from boyhood he was telling Hare Krishna. He had not gone to any school. Nothing. The dear Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that, hey, you are the Vaishnava, Acharya of now. So, but you know, Rupa Goswami, he used to, it has never been told that how many rounds he was doing. Yeah. Raghunath Das Goswami, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it is known. Why? Because he used to take Dimala Vimihan and chanting Hare Krishna and at once sing Krishna, dancing, playing with boys and having so many modes, and he became faint, rolling down. Then who will count all these things? So he is more superior than Haridas Thakur, because Haridas Thakur is Brahma or Prahlad, and he is Rupamanjari, Pratimanjari. Their names are really name, Krishna himself, no difference between Naam and Naam. And that name is Sadhya, not Sadhana. But the Haridas Thakur name is Sadhana. Though he has crossed the level of Sadhana, but if you will go in his line and follow, then it will be. But after that, like Haridas Thakur we chant, then Prem will come. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made him the Namacharya. Brahma is our guru. Prahlad Maharaj is bona fide Vaishnava. From birth he was Vaishnava. Seeing everywhere Krishna and respecting all. So he is telling that. Krishna bhakti rasa bhavita mati kuryatam kutopi jati labhyate tatra lokam upamudyate janma sukhi koti. If you are doing koti koti, sukriti, even the planet has this very lengthy, deep,
great,
in Krishna in Sakha Vasanya. It is very nice. If any bona fide person like this, Rashi Tattavga, having so much boats, then this should be, even our heads, to serve them and to dish on them. And our greed will be so thick. And we may gallop Shraddha, Nishtha, and then coming to Ruchi and Asha. We have seen so many Vaishnavas like this. Like Billu Mangal Thakur, he was so wretched person. Yes, he was so much lusty. No bhakti at all, but by the association of that prostitute, he was bona fide Krishna. Only he has come to help Yudhama. So he has done pranam to this Chintamani, and he had told that, yeah, Jayati.
Chintamani
Chayati Som Guru Guru Me. He has done pranam to that. So we should try to understand all these things. I will explain very, very Dhire dhire. I will have to leave here perhaps 2-3 days more.
5 days? Then morning,
we can explain. I can explain only for you devotees, not for general person. In general also, I will give lecture, general lectures. And don't what? Eat and drink and be merry. We are not so. This body is not so. All these things of Gita and of Srimad Bhagavatam. What our last night I told. Our life half going in sleeping and half eating, drinking and merry. And 10 years in marrying any good lady or with any husband and yielding some children, supporting the children. Very, very big problems comes for their education and nursing. And then so many desires, what you desire. And how to and when to serve Krishna. This way, we need to give lectures. Labdha sudurlabham nidam bhavsham. And in devotee, I will try to help them to gradually advancing in bhakti yoga, whether it is of Vaidhi bhakti or not. So we will tell all things in Vaidhi bhakti. And we will describe something for Raghunatha Bhakti that agreed may come to real bhakti. Though want to serve Krishna as the mood of Raja for him. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come also for this. All our gurus and acharyas. Chaitanya Charitamrita. If anyone is reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, he must have. If animal read very patiently and very deep with any realized soul, then he must have that greed. If animal read the books of proofs and verdict, surely it will come. I request you to hear and go deep in the meaning of all these things. You should try to go deep in the purpose of Swamiji. I think they read like this, all this. Also, he has read. You can go deep, be patient. Very patient. Oh, I'm not understanding. Oh Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, please be merciful to me. Oh Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, merciful to me. You should manage that. I should understand. At once Krishna or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have mercy and he will make understand all these things. Or he will send any bona fide Vaishnava. Oh go, go. Like Krishna has sent Swamiji. You have not done any request from him when he came first. Anyone has done? No request, nothing he came by the order of this. You have not called me, anyone you have called me. You have not given any invitation to me that, oh Maharaj, you should come. I think that Krishna has sent, Swamiji has sent, my Gurudev has sent. He saw that there are some devotees, you should do.
Oh, from Siliguri Day at around 11 o'clock. All are welcome. If you... Yeah. Well, on Wednesday, tomorrow evening there will be a program in Berkeley.
Not here.
Address is here. It will be at the Village Brotherhood Hall. There will be also many devotees from Berkeley coming there, as I understand. And all our friends, anyone we'd like to invite is welcome there. Before that, we'll visit the house of Shyamala Didi. And
Hello.
All are welcome.
What time?
We'll go there in the evening. The program is between 7 and 9 o'clock. And before that, we'll visit the house of Shyamala Didi. Shyamala Didi. Then the next day, we'll have a program in San Francisco in the morning. We'll go there starting from here around 9:30, 10 o'clock. And Gurudas, one of the senior first disciples of Srila Swami Maharaj, he has offered to give a tour in Hendrick Street, Golden Gate Park, and then we'll have a picnic in the park. And in the evening there will be a program in that same area, San Francisco, and Srila Gurudev will rest anywhere in one house before the program so that he doesn't have to come back here and drive there again. So the next day again there will be a program here in the morning and evening program also here. That is on Thursday. And Friday also program in morning and evening will be here. And then Saturday morning we'll be leaving for Eugenie in Oregon.
Good old Princess Eugenie, right?
Srila Prabhupada's first deities at ISKCON are in Berkeley. Jagannath Balabhadra. The temple president had ISKCON and he instructed all the devotees that if you come, you should be treated very well.
Inviting us.
They won't allow you to speak.
Only for darshan. If Vaishnava will not speak about Hari Vaishnava,
how are you? Srila Gurudev, one thing you need to know is that the shoes at Srila Prabhupada's lotus feet at the Berkeley Temple, Gurudas said they're not Srila Prabhupada's shoes, but they're Gurudas' shoes, and they gold plated them. And he's told them several times that they're his shoes, and not Srila Prabhupada's shoes, so you don't have to...
That's great!
Good advice.
We can see what we make.